Welcome to Get Moving TV. I'm Dr. Chris Landon, and I serve as your host. In 1977, I graduated from medical school and did my internship up at Stanford, and my very first patient was a young man named Michael Clark. And Michael was an obnoxious adolescent with a disease called cystic fibrosis. He wouldn't take a vitamin unless it was purple, and I found the purple vitamin, became a hero. Michael passed on 2 years later. Cystic fibrosis, finally the day has arrived when I don't have to say it's the most common lethal genetic disease in the Caucasian population. We have invested tremendous amounts, and we have in May is Cystic Fibrosis Month. We have a great strides activities. We need the funds to cure this this disease. And the cure is in sight. When the gene was discovered, it looked like we were right there. We were going to be able to inject genes into the lungs. That didn't quite work out. We're a little different design. We're a cystic fibrosis center here in Ventura. We serve San Luis Obispo, Santa Barbara County, Ventura County, Kern County. Patients come from at times hundreds of miles away to come to a team. They took away some of our funding so that they could work on this cure for cystic fibrosis. They had plates of every chemical known to God and man, water from the Dead Sea, trying to find something that already existed that could help change what happens with these genes. And with me today is the fortunate result of what happened.
Very lucky.
So Emily, before we had newborn screening, and so now I have kinds of cystic fibrosis, we're detecting it so early, we used to have to go by symptoms. And so when were you first diagnosed?
I was diagnosed when I was just a toddler. Most of my symptoms were GI related. I think I had a cough and a wheeze, but it was pretty minor then.
So we used to have to think about doing sweat chlorides. You just go, gosh, they're just not thriving. Maybe a little more diarrhea.
Right.
Why aren't things going right? And it would be kind of a back thought in our mind. It's not the very first thing.
Right. I think they tried a few different things before they finally decided to test me for CF.
And so you ended up in a CF center then?
No, I saw a pulmonologist for a really long time. I saw a family practitioner and then a pulmonologist. And then when I was in college in my early 20s, I was just very skinny and I had a horrible appetite and my lung function was starting to drop a little. And I found a team of doctors that could help all the different symptoms instead of just the lungs. So that really changed everything for me.
When we look at the gene, it's on the long arm of chromosome 7 on the 508th amino acid position. There is a deletion of phenylalanine, and oh my gosh, but it turns out there's several thousand kinds of cystic fibrosis. And so now we're really concentrating on the gene. The future is here. When I watch Gattaca with Uma Thurman and Ethan Hawke about, you know, how she would take a lock of his hair, go to the ATM and see if he's a worthwhile mate. Oh my gosh, it's really here. So your genotype is one that responds to this medication. So what's your genotype and how did they come to actually want to measure it at all?
I can only think of one, and that's the G551D. I'm not sure what my other is. It's also very rare, odd. So I feel really, really blessed that I got to get this drug early. I just couldn't believe it. I'd been following it for years and years in the studies, so it was great.
One thing that's happened, Bruce Marshall from the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation said, if we just do everything we know how to do with nutrition and airway clearance, then we can, and get patients to do it.
Compliance is important.
That people could live 5 to 10 years longer just doing the things we know how to do.
Right.
And so that's really what we concentrated on. With the cystic fibrosis gene, it's sitting right there in the DNA, and it has to make it through the endoplasmic reticulum and then make it to the surface of the cell. And then that one final step, the G551D, is opening it up. So what medication are you taking? Who's the manufacturer? That it's such a rare disease. In the United States, do you know about how many people have that particular mutation?
I think there's 1,200. I don't know how many can actually take the drug due to age and the study limits. So not very many.
So the cost of the drug to develop all that is in the tens of millions of dollars. And do you know the cost of the drug?
A month, it is $24,500. My cost is virtually nothing. I have very good, very expensive insurance, and I also applied for GHPP insurance, so that's been great. Vertex Pharmaceuticals has called me and helped coordinate all my pharmacy needs. The online pharmacy that I'd been using didn't want to ship it out because it was so expensive, and the insurance didn't want to cover it if it was being shipped, so now I pick it up at the local pharmacy, and so it's been really easy, easier than I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to be impossible to get. I was telling my parents, you know, I don't know, we're going to have to plan for this, and so it's been great.
Yeah. So, and then the other thing that we've learned by is I have a lot of young adults now, and just before we bring on our next guest, tell me the kinds of things that you do, because you, as your parents at 18 months were told you had cystic fibrosis, they looked it up in Encyclopedia Britannica and saw the statistics that I saw 30 years ago. So what are you doing now?
Now, oh God, it's so hopeful now. I was really blessed with good health for most of my life. It really wasn't until I was a teen that I had symptoms that were severe. And then as I got into my early 20s, the fatigue was just unbearable. And so now with this new drug, God, I just hope that I can kind of stay plateaued.
But is that, you work in a winery?
I'm working at a winery on Saturdays.
What's the name of the winery?
It's Stoltman Vineyards, and that's in Los Olivos.
Okay.
And I also work at UCSB Recreation and Exercise Sports Studies during the week. And they've just been wonderful. I can work out on my lunch break and eat at my desk and have fresh air, and it's just wonderful. So.
Well, Emily, thank you so much. We're going to bring on another guest now.
Great.
So we'll be right back.
Perfect.
Didn't hurt a bit. Welcome back. We have a guest with the same genetic disease, Chris. Now, for me, when I was in training, people got to 19 or 20 or 21. We were very excited. Occasionally, 28 would appear out. How old are you, Chris?
I will be 50 next month.
So at 50, were you diagnosed then later in life?
I was diagnosed from birth.
So, and it's because it's in your family, and you had some brothers who passed on?
I had two brothers. My first brother was born in 1961. And when he was diagnosed, he passed away when he was 11 months. My younger brother, which they'd said by then that usually three children won't have this, but.
Right.
He was also born with it in 1964, and he passed away in 1996. So I guess I'm just the stubborn one that keeps fighting.
Well, the stubborn one and waiting for this to occur.
Yes.
I think that's with the work of the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation, with our Great Strides Walks, and Vertex. When these companies make they're looking at just such a small number of people. This isn't blood pressure medications or cholesterol.
Right.
This is a small number of people, and yet they're making this investment for you.
They are, and believe me, we can't thank them enough for this, because this has altered my life since I started on this in December.
Now, I work a lot on airway clearance, and we have devices, the high-frequency
yes.
chest wall oscillators, and we have antibiotics and enzymes and so forth, but a lot of my patients with cystic fibrosis end up being very thin. Of course, the girls, oh, you're so lucky, you're so thin. Oh, you look just like a Vogue model. But that's not good for their health.
No.
Has this medication had any effect on your weight?
I did. Within the first few weeks of starting on this, I started to gain weight. And so far, I've increased about 8-9 pounds in weight.
And then your regimen in terms of airway clearance, what kinds of things would you do to get you through your teens, 20s, 30s, 40s?
Well, actually, as in my teens and 20s, 30s, I basically just worked out. Worked out really hard, a lot of exercising, karate, bicycling. I used to go on regular weekend bicycle rides. And back then, there really wasn't much in the line of medication that we could take, and they still know very little about it.
So over the last, let's say, 10 years or so, you've been working for, who have you been working for?
I work for Quest Diagnostics, and I work for the Clinical Trials Division. So I was aware that Vertex was going to be working on a new drug, which one of our project managers kindly informed me about. So from the day they started, I have followed the progress on that.
And so over the last several years, you got a cystic fibrosis team and got a tune-up. We take our car in for new spark plugs and oil change, filter.
Yeah, and I would highly recommend those, because they really work wonders to clean your lungs out, to clean everything out, and you go in there and you come out feeling like a new person.
And so that's about 2 weeks in the hospital?
That depends on the situation. I went in and I had the bronchoscopy and the sinus surgery as well, so sometimes it may be a couple extra weeks.
So you're in the hospital and it's somewhere between $3,000 and $6,000 a day for hospitalization.
Yes.
What kind of bills, did you actually ever look at any of those
bills?
Well,
look, I did look at those, and they are pretty expensive, ranging anywhere from $250,000 to $450,000. But the company I work for has really good insurance for us, and they've also been very helpful with my time off work and my health, so I'm really thankful for the company I work for.
Yeah, because with this medication, I mean, with my patients who are in their 30s and 40s, they're really basically spending 6 hours a day on their health, between airway clearance, inhaling medications, taking pills, working out, doing all the things that I say. It doesn't leave much time for a...
Well, I do my still do my respiratory medications, and I have the vest for airway clearance. So I do 45 minutes in the morning, 45 minutes in the evening. Then I spend about an hour and a half working out, which is working out with weights, and also I have an exercise bike that I usually tend to do 30 minutes on that.
So tell me just a little bit more about your brothers. So you made a commitment to them.
Yeah, it's basically my older brother passed before I was born, but my younger brother, and I told him, well, you know, we've got to keep going here. So I promised him I would stay around, you know, to make sure we saw a cure for this. And I promised my mother that as well.
Well,
so I make sure she didn't have to, you know, bury all three of us.
Well, I'm so glad that you made, it's a big leap too.
Yes.
That could have affected your liver, it could have affected other parts, and that you were able to participate in the trials and come out with a medication that's really halted this illness altogether.
It's made a big difference. Like I said, I feel like a whole new person.
All right, Christopher. Well, thank you for being a whole new person
thank
for
you.
Us.
Thank
and,
you very much.
We'll be right back. We have some good health coming, and exercise, eat right, nutrition, and there is something to science, too.
Cut. Good job.
Sorry.
Thank you.
That's right, sir.
Thank you.